إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وكل محدثة بدعة. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وكل بدعة ضلالة. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وكل ضلالة في النار. Every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثم أما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, many of us follow the crowd. We follow the majority. But it doesn't always mean that that's what's right. And now more than ever, we need to realize this and we have to not follow blindly what appears to be the masses or the majority or the crowd. Sometimes when we advise somebody to leave a sin or an innovation or to follow something, they respond with, everybody's doing it. It's not just me. Or this is what we've always done. Or they respond by saying, few people do this, or nobody does this, or I haven't seen anybody doing it like this. With respect to acts of ibadah, and we see nowadays children, the youth, even the adults, respond this way, answering with this ignorance, with these ignorant statements. When you look at the Quran, which is the best of speech, khayrul kalam, the best of words, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we see that when Allah says about most people, when He refers to the majority, you will find that most people are, when you're looking at the majority, they are on the wrong path. Allah says, وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Allah says, and however, most people do not know about when the Day of Judgment is. For example, we might have some who say they believe in the Day of Judgment, but it's not really a reality to them. It's not really a day that they truly believe in where they will be risen or resurrected, عفواً, and questioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَشْكُرُونَ. And most people do not show gratitude. They're not thankful to Allah. They don't count their blessings. And even the ones who count their blessings, they're still missing many of them. As Allah said, وَإِن تَعُدُّ نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْسُوهَا. And if you were to count the blessings and favors of Allah, you would never be able to enumerate them. Most people do not show gratitude. They covet wealth and prestige and status. So most of the people from creation, they're not thankful to Allah. And to our ummah, this would be one of the biggest crimes. Blessed with al-qawl, alhamdulillah. Qawl tamla'u al-mizan. It is a phrase that fills the scales. It is a phrase that gives you a lot of reward. A phrase that we read in Surah Al-Fatiha at least 17 times a day if you just pray the fara'id. A beautiful phrase to bring peace to your heart, alhamdulillah. Yet most people do not show gratitude. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. And Allah says, and most of the people, they do not believe. Because many people may say the statement with their tongue, but it's not really in their heart. Some may say, my iman is in my heart. But they may not state it with their tongue, or if they do, they may not follow through with their actions. وَالْإِيمَانَ تَصْدِيقُ الْقَلْبِ وَالْقَوْلُ بِاللِّسَانِ أَوْ عَلَى اللِّسَانِ وَالْعَمَلُ بِالْجَوَارِحِ. Iman, true faith and belief, is that you believe it in your heart and you speak it with your tongue and your actions of your limbs fulfill the covenants Allah ordered you to do, the things Allah ordered you to do. If you look at the Quran, when Allah refers to most of them, you will find that most of them are again leading a path of disobedience. Allah says, وَأَنَّ أَكْثَرَكُمْ فَاسِقُونَ. And indeed, most of you are definitely disobedient. And this was revealed towards Ahlul Kitab, to the people of the book, for criticizing the Muslims just for believing in Tawheed and wanting it to be a pure belief. Pure belief in the oneness of Allah, associating no partners with Him, not claiming Him to have a son or a daughter or a mother and the likes of these matters. Yet now we have Muslims even criticizing this topic, this Tawheed, this purity of worshipping Allah alone without any partners. And you have Muslims who will mock these subjects or these scholars who are constantly discussing Tawheed and Aqeedah. And we should know, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, that the most important thing that we have is that Tawheed and that Aqeedah of the righteous predecessors, those who came before us from the companions and the Tabi'een and the Tabi'een. It's even more important than the Salah. That your foundation is correct in your belief. وَقَالَ اللَّهُ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرُهُمْ يَجْهَلُونَ. And Allah says, what means, and yet most of them are ignorant, living in ignorance. Most of the people, they choose this ignorance. Because instead of seeking knowledge in their deen, they're seeking knowledge for an advancement in their dunya. The reason for this ignorance is the lack of knowledge. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم طلب العلم فريدة على كل مسلم. That the seeking of knowledge is a faridah, it's an obligation upon every Muslim, the male and the female. Yet most of the people choose ignorance. They choose to not know. Some do it so that they don't have to fulfill it, because if they knew they had to do something, then it would be quote unquote harder on them. So they choose to be ignorant. And they memorize these facts that will bring them no benefit in knowledge. عن جابر رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سل الله علما نافعا وتعوذ بالله من علم لا ينفع رواه ابن ماجه وهذا حديث حسن. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, ask Allah for beneficial knowledge. Make this one of your ad'iyah, one of your du'a. In the morning, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he would wake up, he would say, Allahumma inni as'aluka ilman nafi'an. O Allah, I'm asking, begging of you to give me beneficial knowledge. Wa rizqan tayyiban. And a pure provision, pure wealth. Ilman nafi'an wa rizqan tayyiban wa amalan mutaqabbala. And to give me actions and deeds which you will accept from me and reward me for. This is what the Prophet ﷺ would say when he awoken from his bed. So ask Allah for that beneficial knowledge. But what fills our minds and our memories now is garbage. Nothing of benefit. What fills our minds, what takes up the stores of memory in our brains, is lyrics of music from even 20, 30 years. Stats, facts, figures, scores of games. Who the best is, what they're matching your cars, all of these things. This is what comes into the people's minds and consumes them. And the topics of siyasa, of politics, learning history about lands and this and that in their countries, that's all fine and dandy to an extent. But how much time is wasted? How much memory is stored of non-beneficial knowledge? Whereas the knowledge of your deen, the path for you to get to Jannah, the knowledge that you have in your brains is very little. وَقَالَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ وَأَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ الْحَقَّ فَهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ. And Allah says what means, yet most of them do not know the truth. They don't know the truth. They deny it out of arrogance. And for some, out of ignorance. They deny the truth, so they are turning away from Allah and His remembrance. So this is the majority. This is the largest of the groups. This is the crowd. So if we follow the majority or if we follow the crowd, you're ending up in areas, groups of people That the size of them doesn't mean anything. You're ending up in disobedience most of the time. So be of those who are the few. Be of those whom Allah, He referred to them as, yani, the few of the people. And look what Allah says of them. This is not the majority, not the crowd. A small group, a few of His slaves. قَالَ اللَّهُ وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورِ And few of my servants are grateful. Be of this few group that always thanks Allah and praises Allah. Alhamdulillah, when good happens to you. Alhamdulillah ala kulli hal. Praise be to Allah and thanks be to Allah for every situation that Allah gives me in times of hardness. This is the ajaba al-amr al-mu'min. This is the strangeness for the believer. In asabathu kulluhu khair. Anything that happens to him or her, it's always good. In asabathu sarra shakara fa kana khayrun lahu. If Allah blesses him with good, he is thankful to Allah. He doesn't give that goodness, yeah, he doesn't give that credit to his hard work or something he did. And this is better for him. وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ ضَرَّاءُ صَبَرَ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ But if hardship comes his way, he is patient with it. And this is better for him. This is the few. So this should be heavy on the Muslim's tongue. Alhamdulillah, because it weighs down the scales. And thank Allah for everything that Allah has given us, knowing that we will never be able to enumerate and thank Allah for everything He's given us and blessed us with. Every atom, every cell in our body, of the millions or billions of cells, wallahu a'lam, provides a function for you to get through your life. وَقَالَ اللَّهُ وَمَا آمَنَ مَعْهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ And Allah said, what means, but none have believed with Him except a few. There are few believers. We see from the previous nations, and even there are many who claim Islam as their deen, but may not be believers with Allah. It was said about Prophet Nuh alayhi salam that in his 950 years, Allahu a'lam, of living, that he only had 8 or 9 or maybe 100 followers. Few really believe. Few truly believe. Yet many, the crowd, the majority, they are heedless and have gone astray. وَقَالَ اللَّهُ فِي جَنَّاتِ النَّعِيمِ ثُلَّةٌ مِّنَ الْأَوَّلِينَ وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنَ الْآخَرِينَ In gardens of bliss, a large company of the former people and a few of the later peoples, a few of the later generations. Allah said, السابقون الأولون من المهاجرين والأنصار والذين اتبعوهم بإحسان رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه Allah says what means the first to believe from the muhajirin and the ansar, the earlier generations, the muhajirin, those who migrated from Mecca to Medina with the Prophet ﷺ, the ansar, the residents of Medina who welcomed them and gave them refuge and home and a place to rest and to take as their homes. Those earlier generations and those who follow them in that goodness, those who follow them exactly in faith, Allah is well pleased with them and they are well pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The earlier generations were more in populist belief. Their tawheed, their aqidah was correct and they didn't have the deviations to the level that we're seeing them today. Yet every generation after may increase their in belief. Yani, those who are believing are fewer. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said, go on the path of truth and do not feel lonely because there are few who take that path. Never feel lonely if what you're doing has a basis in the Quran and the Sunnah. Go forth, be that few group, be the few of that group. And beware of the path of falsehood and do not be deceived by the vastness of its perishers. Don't worry about how many people are following a thing because they could be on misguidance, they could be on bid'ah and innovation. And that would be surely a wrong path for you to follow. So even if you feel like you're the only one in your family, if you're the black sheep because of what you stick to of the deen, take pride in that and know that you should stick upon that path. May Allah make us from His few servants who fulfill the Quran and the Sunnah. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بدأ الإسلام غريب وسيعود غريبا فقوبا للغرباء The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said in the Sunan of Ibn Majah in a hadith which is sahih he said Islam began as something strange This pure tawheed was a strange concept to the Arab, to the mushrikeen of the Arab. It was a pure concept of worshipping only Allah with no partners. They believed that Allah was the Lord of the heavens and the earth. But they worshipped other than Him and they associated and worshipped with Him. They denied worshipping Allah alone. That tawheed al-uluhiyya, that you only worship Allah alone without any partners. This is what came with Islam. Islam began as something strange. And it will go back to being strange to the point where people question, what is this that you're doing? And it's actually a sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, but it's been so died down that nobody knows about it. So they'll think the one following the sunnah is the innovator. وَالْعَيَادُ بِاللَّهِ Islam began as something strange and it will go back to being strange. فَتُوبَى لِلْغُرَبَاءِ So glad tidings be to the strangers. Be a stranger. You don't have to be popular. Not everyone has to like you. Be the black sheep if you have to be the black sheep, as they say in that method here in America. It doesn't matter. Because to your Lord, you're going to be of the most prized people to enter Jannah. So many forgotten sunnahs that when the people see them, they say to the one who's doing it, what is this innovation that you are doing? And this is truly what we have come upon in our ummah. An Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يأتي على الناس زمان الصابر فيهم على دينه كالقابض على الجمر. The Prophet ﷺ, he said in this hadith, which is Hasan in the Sunnah of Tirmidhi, there shall come a time upon the people in which one who is patient upon his deen, patient to take the hardship, the criticism, the mocking of even his or her fellow Muslims, there will become a time upon the people in which the one who is patient upon his deen, he adheres to what is revealed, he doesn't manipulate it to fit life in 2021 or whatever it is, he will be like the one who's holding on to a burning coal or an ember. I don't know many people who could hold on to something that is burning. I can't even get near the stove without having to pull my hand away, and I'm not even touching the flame. But to hold on to a burning coal, this is what it feels like when you're holding on to the haqq, when you're holding on to the truth. Because of all the pressure to deviate from the truth, this is shaitan's plot. And he's deceived many of the Muslims to come into it. This is how hard it is to hold on to your deen, but do it. Do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do it for the sake of your soul entering Jannah. This is the sacrifices you must make. أَقُولُ قَالِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ إِذُوا اللَّهَ يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وبعد. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, following the crowd or the majority isn't usually what's right. Those who are upon the haqq, we've been told by our deen and we can see it in reality, is the group that's considered the few. Not the crowd, not the majority. So whatever hardships come your way in that, never let it deviate you from being upon the truth. So many are dropping the deen because of love of this dunya and fear of the people. And it's what makes them let go of their Islam. Allah is the one who should be feared. The deen is what will save you in this life and the next. And if you don't believe it, then you're taking your chances, as they may say, with what may happen to you in this life and the next. عن ثوبان رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا يزال طائفة من أمتي على الحق منصورين لا يضرهم من خالفهم حتى يأتي أمر الله عز وجل. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, a group amongst my ummah will continue to follow the truth and prevail. They'll be little in number. A group amongst my ummah will continue to follow the truth and prevail, and those who oppose them will not be able to harm them until the command of Allah comes to pass. Until the command of Allah comes to pass. There will always be a group upon the haqq. So be of the strangers, be of the ghurabat. Those you may be strange to all the people, but to Allah, you're one He loves because of your adherence to the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So do not follow the crowd or the majority. Allah has informed us that they are in the wrong. Know that the Quran and the Sunnah are the revelations from Allah. As Allah said, وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيُّ يُوحَىٰ. That the Prophet that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said about the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he does not speak out of his own desire. It is only an inspiration that is inspired. Everything we have from the Sunnah, everything we have from the Sunnah is wahi, it is revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Ubad ibn Samit, he said to his son, قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ إِنَّكَ لَن تَجِدْ طَعْمَ حَقِيقَةِ الْإِيمَانِ حَتَّى تَعْلَمْ أَنَّ مَا أَصَابَكَ لَمْ يَكُنْ لِيُخْطِئَكَ وَمَا أَخْطَأَكَ لَمْ يَكُنْ لِيُصِيبَكَ سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إن أول ما خلق الله القلم فقال له اكتب فقال ربي وماذا أكتب قال اكتب مقادير كل شيء حتى تقوم الساعة يا بني إني سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من مات على غير هذا فليس مني رواه أبو داود وهذا حديث صحيح. This authentic hadith, Ubad ibn Samit, he said to his son, you will not get the taste of the reality of faith until you know that what has come to you could not miss you. And that what has missed you was never meant to get to you or to come to you. I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying the first thing that Allah created was the pen. He told the pen to write. The pen said, my Lord, what shall I write? And Allah told the pen, write down everything that is decreed until the last hour comes. He said, son, I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, whoever dies upon something other than this does not belong to me. Whoever does not believe in this qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not belong to the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So what are we trying to create for ourselves in our lives by following the crowd? Last week the khutbah was on your niyyah, your intention. Sincerity, the sincerity of your intention. What is behind every action you do? And what are you afraid to miss? What are you striving so hard to achieve in this dunya when you're promised that this dunya will end? It's a promise from Allah, this dunya will come to an end. So identify your goals for this life. And if they're not for the akhirah, then you're going to lose out on two lives, this one and the next one. So this is a time, my brothers and sisters in Islam, to be cautious. Do not let fear make you just want to assimilate and blend in. Be proud that you're a Muslim, believe it or not. This is the time that it's like holding on to that burning coal. Follow it more than ever. Even if it means your family or your friends or those around you reject you. Show your deen inwardly and outwardly. Regardless of what the majority is doing. Do not follow the masses, nor be of those who act in fear or leave their deen. The majority you find of the world getting into drinking alcohol and intoxicants and khamr. Should you follow them? You find the majority dating, wanting to have relations with the opposite gender unlawfully, committing zina. Should we follow them? You find the majority of the people of this ummah not coming to pray in the masjid, knowing that the reward is greater to pray in the masjid. And you have those who don't even pray or don't even pray on time, because this is also something that is part of the prayer that is done within its time for it to be accepted. Should we follow them? Since the majority of the Muslims are praying at home instead of in the masjid, when Allah had the masjid established by His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam for the people to come together, and the majority are sitting at home, so should we follow them? This is what you need to reflect upon. It's time to make that change if you want to save yourself. You have Allah on your side. Even remember the Battle of Badr, when Allah, He sent thousands of angels. So even though the Muslims were few, they defeated the largeness of the mushrikeen, the large army of the mushrikeen, because Allah sent the angels to aid them. So how will anyone ever learn, even from fellow Muslims who are ignorant of the truth, if we do not show them what a Muslim is, or how a Muslim, or who a Muslim really is? This comes to you showing your deen. The smallest of things help. Stop changing your name from Muhammad to Mo, or Larry, or Jack, or whatever else people change their names to. Don't change your name. Let the people say the name. Let your deen be known. Now is the time to focus on our deen and to be distinct and to be different. Look at that, the blessing, the best of them. That Allah found us lost and He guided us to this deen. Allah says, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا وَاذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَةِ إِخْوَانًا وَكُنْتُمْ عَلَى شَفَا حُفْرَةٍ مِنَ النَّارِ فَأَنْقَذُكُمْ مِنْهَا كَذَلِكَ يُبَيِّنُ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ آيَاتِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَهْتَدُونَ. Allah says, what means that hold fast, all of you together, to the rope of Allah, to this Quran, to this book, which in it has the command to stick to and follow the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and be not divided amongst yourselves. This division is of course only on the haqq. Those who are not on the haqq, they have divided themselves from us. And remember Allah's favor on you, for you were enemies one to another, but He joined your hearts together, so that by His grace you would become brothers and sisters in faith. And you were on the brink of a pit of fire, and Allah saved you from that fire. Thus Allah makes His ayat, His proofs and His evidences, His lessons, clear to you that you may be guided. Allah said, وَوَجَدَكَ ضَالًا فَهَدَى. And He found you unaware of this Qur'an, its legal laws, the prophethood, and He guided you to it. This is a ni'mah, being guided to the best, being guided to being of the best of people, the best of the people that Allah created for the earth. It's a ni'mah to being guided to Islam, the only deen Allah will accept. كَمَا قَالَ إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. That the religion with Allah is al-Islam. It's the only deen He will accept. It is a blessing and a favor Allah guided you to this. So do not fall victims to the plots and the traps of those trying to lie and distort or intimidate or manipulate the situation. This is coming from within the Muslim body, the Muslim ummah, as well as from the non-Muslims, to the point where they try and say, if you go to pray in the masjid, you're an extremist. That's not true. If you grow your lihya, you're an extremist. Not true. If you wear the hijab or the niqab, you're an extremist. Not true. Do not let the people fool you into distancing, and then you distance yourself away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we need to stop destroying ourselves from within by stopping this distortion of our deen and just following it the way it was revealed by Allah to His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you cannot hold your ground in this country, if you cannot hold true to your deen as it was revealed, keeping in mind that Allah does not need us, then I advise you to make hijrah and go back to the Muslim lands. Go back to a Muslim land and live there. Migrate to a land where you can hold on to your deen. Because being here and the land of opportunity or whatever else it promises is not worth you losing your Islam. But this land does afford for us to practice our deen and open our masajid and come to the prayers. Yet we have from within ourselves this distortion of what being too extreme is. This distortion of changing our deen because it's 2021. So I advise myself and you to get away from this line of thinking. Allah says, وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبَلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ ذَلِكُمْ وَصَّاكُمْ بِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Allah says what means, and verily this, Allah's commandments, is my straight path, so follow it, and follow not other paths, for they will separate you from His path, away from His path, from the path of Allah. This He has ordained for you that you may become al-muttaqoon, so that you can become of the people who have taqwa. So stick to the path of Allah. Do not follow the crowds or the majority, because most of the time, they're the ones who are along the wrong path. Be of the ghurabat, the strangers, the few that hold on to the Quran and the Sunnah, and do not change or manipulate the religion in any way to suit their own desires or their whims. May Allah make us from those who follow what is the truth and are firm upon that truth. and make us of those who enter Jannah. Allahumma ameen. Allahumma khil al-muslimina wal-muslimat wal-mu'minina wal-mu'minat al-ahya'i minhum wal-amwat innaka anta sami'un qareeb al-mujib al-da'wat ya muqallib al-qulub thabit qulubina ala deenik subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salaman ala al-mursaleen walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.